Welcome! We're here with Lunch with the Doc. Tarana's with us today.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, guys. So today we're going to be talking about cooking with essential oils. It's going to be really fun. And we got Coldplay going because it's such a fall-like day. Yeah, yeah.
How much do you love Coldplay?
I love Coldplay.
And the fall.
And the fall. It was like raining the other day and I was just like, oh, getting all the fall vibes. So today we're going to really get into those fall vibes with some fall recipes, cooking, and just, this is the time of year to really like go into that sweet space of enjoying your kitchen, enjoying good food, and we're just going to give you the tools to do that today. But it's exciting because we're doing it specifically with essential oils. So I'm going to let Tarana talk a little bit about essential oils, why we want to cook with essential oils, but the benefits of that are how to do it safely and well, and kind of give the introduction, and then we'll go into our recipes for the day. So, Tarana, thank you for being with us.
Thanks for having me. Really happy to be here. I love doTERRA essential oils, and I love having fun and cooking with them. Well, we can get started, but before we do that, I just want to mention something really quick. You know, our oils are certified pure therapeutic grade, so that makes them actually safe to ingest. But something I would like to just mention is on our bottles, the oils that can be ingested have a label that says supplement fact on there. Mm-hmm. While most of our oils, you know, are food grade, some of them are not. So I just want to put that disclaimer out there before we get started.
It's important.
It's very, very important to use these oils safely. Mm-hmm. So again, always be sure to check the back of the bottles. Make sure it says supplement fact.
Yes.
But I love using the essential oils, obviously for the therapeutic benefits. Mm-hmm. You know, you can use it aromatically, you can use it topically. But it's so much fun to use them in your food and to cook with them. It's a great flavoring.
So
yeah, it's a great flavoring agent. It's mm-hmm. fun. So I'm super excited to be here today. We got a few recipes, a few different oils we're going to be using and showcasing. And as we're cooking with the oils, I will be mentioning the different ways of using them and when it's appropriate to use the oils. I'll just mention something real quick too. I really like using the oils if I'm cooking something at the end of the cooking process. It tends to hold the flavors longer, so that's just one little tip for you guys out there. I also really like for colder recipes, like a salad, when I make a salad dressing with our citrus oils, I like to first mix it in with the olive oil and then spread it on the salad, as opposed to just putting little drops all over the salad. Mm-hmm. It's nice when you dilute it that way, and then you convert it and then you spread it over the food. Mm-hmm. So anyways, we'll continue chatting a little bit more as we're going through each recipe. But yeah, I just wanted to mention that important fact, you know, always look at the back of the oils, make sure it says supplement fact before you take it internally.
Yeah.
So let's get started.
Let's get started. Yeah. So today we're going to be making two different recipes. We're going to be doing paleo pumpkin bread, and this recipe is off of Against All Grain. So if you haven't checked out that website, it's awesome. She does, Danielle Walker is the woman who does the blog, and she just has amazing paleo recipes. She has just like a lot of different recipes for people with different food intolerances and stuff, but she makes it so good. So this pumpkin bread is like amazing. So if you're looking for recipes for Thanksgiving, this is a really good one, or just like throughout the season. So we'll be doing that, but what we're going to be adding into it, we're going to be adding On Guard oil, which is our immune oil. It's a protective blend, and this is really good. It has, I'll just tell you the oils that are in it. It has wild orange peel, clove bud, cinnamon leaf, cinnamon bark, eucalyptus leaf, and rosemary leaf. So it's really good for immunity. So we're gonna put it into the bread. We're also gonna be using clove oil, which it calls for clove, you know, just a clove powder in this recipe, but we're gonna substitute with clove oil.
Ooh.
And then we're also gonna be putting cinnamon bark oil, which it calls for cinnamon, but we're gonna do this instead. We're also gonna put lemon oil in it because it calls for lemon juice, and we're gonna do half lemon juice, half lemon oil. So that's gonna be fun. And then we'll bring it over here to where we're gonna be doing our other recipe. So we're gonna be doing marinara sauce. And this one is going to be using oregano oil as well as basil oil. So these oils are super potent and they taste really flavorful in food. And with the marinara sauce, we're gonna be putting it on spaghetti squash, which I don't know if any of you have ever cooked a spaghetti squash. It's really cool. It is a squash. When you put it in the oven, it just looks kind of like a normal squash. And then when it comes out, it looks like spaghetti inside. It like literally naturally just goes to a spaghetti strings. So I'll show you what it looks like right now while it's cooking. It looks kind of normal.
Oh my, look at it.
Here we go. Wow. So there it is cooking. Basically what you do is you cut off the sides, you cut it in half, you take the seeds out. It's kind of like a pumpkin. So you take the seeds out in the middle and then you just half it, put olive oil on it, salt, pepper, and then you put it into the oven on 400.
It's sizzling.
It's sizzling. We might turn it down a little. And it looks super good. So let me see if I can show you the inside, what it looks like while it's cooking. It smells like a pumpkin. Okay, that's what it looks like right now, and then you'll see once it starts cooking more, it's gonna start looking like spaghetti.
Interessante.
Very interessante. Okay, so let's get cooking. Toronto's gonna start dicing the tomatoes for the marinara, and I'm gonna get going with the pumpkin bread. So, like I said, this is a really fun recipe to do for Thanksgiving coming up. Danielle Walker has a Thanksgiving roundup on her website where she kind of does like a bunch of different recipes that you can use for Thanksgiving. So that's a really good way to go. And let's talk a little bit about paleo and why we would go paleo as opposed to, eating normal grains and things. I'm just gonna pull up this recipe against all grain. So.
Got some super ingredients here.
Yeah, let's check out the ingredients. So, I'll read them off to you. So, we're gonna be using, in here we're gonna be using coconut flour, which I love baking with. Coconut flour has a lot better nutritional value than, let's say, just using flour, right? Because we actually have fibers in here, we have different minerals that come in the coconut flour. It actually has some protein in it. So this is one of the components to the bread that is gives it its consistency. We're also gonna be using almond butter instead of flour. And then we're gonna be doing, instead of flour. Yeah, almond butter is gonna act as some of the like substance to the bread. So like I said, why would we go paleo rather than grains? Okay, so a lot of our grains nowadays, one, like a lot of people have gluten intolerance, and that could be from different things based on the way that our wheat is processed. It's not how it used to be because of all the cross-pollination and the different farming techniques, so a lot of people have become allergic to gluten. So that's one way we want to stay away, reason we want to stay away from gluten. And then away from grains, there's other grain intolerances that people have as well. So doing something paleo, you're focusing more on nuts and coconut and there's like cassava root. I think it's technically a fruit.
Why does it say coconut?
That is a great question, Raya. And I don't really know the answer to that.
Hmm.
But we could look it up.
Seems curious.
Seems quite curious. All right, so I'm gonna start going through this. We're gonna start with the eggs and butter and maple syrup. Okay, maple syrup, another thing. So maple syrup is a really good thing to use for sweetener as opposed to sugar.
You think we can post the recipes on the website after this?
We can definitely post the recipes on the website. So all you out there who are like, want to cook that? Well, you're gonna be able to, because we're gonna post these recipes up for you, and then you'll just get everything you need everything you need. That's what we want to give you. Okay?
How many eggs?
Almond butter. 3 eggs. And then almond butter, we're going to go with 3/4 cup. You can also do sunflower butter, which is good too. Because if you have a nut, I'm going to walk over here and get a spoon. Some people have nut intolerances, right? So she even has on there nut-free and grain-free recipes. So you'd ask, how could you even make breads and things with that? Well, she's going to be using coconut flour. She's going to be using sun butter, flaxseed meal, stuff like that. So it's really, she's got it all going on. Okay, so we did our eggs. We're going to do our almond butter. 3/4 cup. Hey, yesterday was Halloween too, so anybody out there, if you want to just comment and tell us what you wore for Halloween, we'd love that. It's fun to hear.
What were you?
I had 2 costumes. Over the weekend, I was the dunk queen. So if any of you...
are familiar with basketball?
Actually, no. You might think, oh, dunking, right? But when I say dunk, in my world, it means dunking in the ocean. It means basically you just run down to the ocean, jump in, do a quick dunk under the water, and you're out. You've gotten your amazing ocean dunk in for the day. So I decided to be pretty much myself for Halloween because I am the dunk queen in real life. If anyone knows me, you know that I'll just go, let's go have a dunk right now. There's always time for a dunk in my world. You know, even if you have to be at work in 40 minutes, you can go dunk. You can do it. Believe me, I've done it many times. It can be done. And I'm not Superwoman, so you just gotta try it. Just gotta get out there because really, there's nothing like dunking in the ocean to just brighten your day.
What does Tarana think about that?
Tarana?
Very creative.
What were you for Halloween?
I was a cat.
Oh, cute.
Yes, I was a cat. I wore very cute ears. Actually, my friends and I, we were trying to do a theme. We were trying to be the 3 blind mice. But we couldn't find mouse ears, so we ended up being 3 blind cats.
Oh my gosh, that's cute.
It was super cute.
Were you running into things all over the place?
What's that?
Were you bumping into doors and people and buildings and cars?
I wasn't running into any of those, but I was having a little trouble seeing because, you know, when it's dark out and you're wearing your sunglasses, it's hard to see.
Mm-hmm.
But it was a lot of fun. We had a great time. We got a lot of compliments. So, I love Halloween.
It's tons of candy, too. Stored up for the next 3 months.
Oh, gosh.
You still trick-or-treat?
No, I do not. and I try to stay away from sugar.
Mo's trick-or-treating last night.
I went out trick-or-treating with my little sister. She had to go. But we went a little late, so, you know, there's barely anybody out there. But we still got a little bit of candy, so that was one for the win. Okay.
One for the win.
One for the win.
Not sure what that means.
I don't know either. I'm just trying to use an expression in my own way. A well-known expression in my way.
What's the well-known expression?
I don't know.
Me either.
Wow. All right, here we go. Now we got the maple syrup going in. So like I was saying, you want to stay away from normal processed sugars, but maple syrup is more of a natural sugar. Look at that.
It's sap.
It is, yeah. You're right. And getting the better grades is much better. You know, there's like Auntie Annie's or something sugar. That is not what I'm talking about using.
It's pseudo syrup.
Pseudo syrup. I'm talking about... maple syrup, 100% pure, grade A amber, rich
Come
taste.
On, rich
I mean, taste. Look at that, 100% pure. That's what you want to get. Okay, so Canadian farmers proudly extract a barley sweet clear sap from their snow-covered maple trees. I mean, how authentic does that sound, right? Mm. If you can get naturally occurring stuff, you're on it. All right, then we do a 1/2 cup of the pumpkin puree. I got organic pumpkin puree from Whole Foods. That looks good. Or even better, you can make your own pumpkin puree.
Oh man, with all those pumpkins from last night?
Yeah, carving those pumpkins, just use it. I'm sure you can look up a great way to just make your own pumpkin puree.
Call the pumpkin in a blender.
Yeah, probably. Okay, so, what's next? Oh, Tarana, could you share with us some other recipes that you do often for cooking with essential oils? Tarana's amazing with this. She has some fun little, like, things that she does for appetizers or parties, desserts.
Do you have a blog, Tarana?
I don't have a blog, but I probably should start one.
Especially all these fun things that everyone wants to know about.
Yeah, no, absolutely. So one of my favorite oils that I like to use is lavender oil.
Mm.
And I love to add it to vanilla frosting on cupcakes. And then I spread it on the vanilla cupcake. And it's just this amazing lavender vanilla flavor. It's super, super yummy. Mm. My friend says it's delicious and de-stressing when she eats it. So lavender is a really, really great one. You don't have to add too many drops, maybe 2-3 drops in the actual the frosting. Just mix it in really, really well. And then I love to actually add some food coloring. I like to add, a little
purple.
A
little purple?
Yeah, a little purple. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. So whenever I have guests over and I bake those, people love it. It's a hit.
You know what would be fun to research is like a natural food coloring, purple food coloring. Like I wonder if you could use beets would be a little more red, but I wonder
purple
if you
carrots.
Could, purple carrots.
Eggplant.
Eggplant, just using the outside, or purple cabbage. I don't know, that'd be an interesting thing to research.
Something you could use.
So you use that. And then I love your apple, the apple thing you do.
Oh, so that's another one I really like, especially during the fall. I love just cutting up some slices of apple, putting it in a bowl of water, and then just adding a drop of either On Guard or cinnamon, and just letting it soak for about 5 to 10 minutes, and then draining the water, and then just eating it as a snack. It's super, super yummy. Just a quick note about cinnamon. Cinnamon is one of our spicy oils. So a few of our spicy oils are clove, cinnamon, oregano. These are the types of oils you always, always want to dilute, whether it's with water or whether it's with olive oil. So just want to let you guys know out there, just don't ever try to put the oil you just need on top of food or bread. Make sure you dilute it just for your safety.
Safety first.
Always.
Okay, I'm going to start adding some of the oils in here so you guys can see what I'm doing. So it calls for the lemon juice.
So nice cooking with Chris Martin too.
Oh, Chris Martin he's really one of our faves.
He's awesome.
I know. I've seen him once.
It's amazing. Best Coldplay was the best concert I've ever been to.
Really?
Yeah, I went last year. It was at the Rose Bowl.
Oh.
I know.
Went last year to San Francisco.
Oh.
Yeah.
It is.
Has anyone out there on the Facebook world seen Coldplay live? What was your experience? Tell us.
Okay, so this calls for 2 teaspoons fresh lemon juice. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just do 1 teaspoon fresh lemon juice, and then I'm going to do 2 drops of lemon oil. All right, so we're going to kind of get both the fresh in there and the oil. What's cool about the oil?
Ooh, here's the oil.
Thank you. Okay, so I'm doing 1 teaspoon of the lemon, and then I'm going to do 2 little drops. Now this lemon is really yummy. It kind of has the flavor of the rind a little bit. So 2 drops.
Oh, 3. Whoop,
3. It's going to be a little lemony. It's going to be great. So the lemon rind has a lot of nutritional and health benefits also. So it actually, the oil comes mostly from the rind, right, Tarana?
Yes.
The lemon oil.
Absolutely.
So it comes from the rind. We're actually going to use some of the rind in here as well. It calls for lemon zest. But lemon is really good for detoxification. It's really good for just that whole cleansing. So if you, what's cool about the lemon is I put this in my water during the day, and because it's made more from the rind, it doesn't have that acidic thing going on your teeth. So it's actually better than like squeezing lemon in your water. Using the oil is a lot better for your teeth, and it's more potent than lemon juice in general. So we use that. All right, now we're gonna mix this all together. And then we're gonna start getting into the coconut flour and everything like that. So let me get another bowl. Check that thing out.
You gotta love a good automatic stir thing.
Oh yeah. Gotta love.
We are cooking it up here.
Cooking it up.
How do we think our squashes are doing? Look at Toronto, just amazing onions, tomatoes. I wonder if they're gonna eat all those things. Check out these squashes.
Oh yeah, check out the squash.
Those things are cooking. How long do those take, Mo?
They take a while. They take about an hour.
Oh.
So they're gonna be in there for a bit. But I started them quite a bit before the show, so hopefully they'll be done, and we can put our lovely marinara sauce on there for you.
Can you set a timer?
You know, I just have it in my mind. I do. That.
You maybe start at 10 minutes before 12:30.
No, I started it at 12:15. So we'll see if it's done.
Probably not.
We'll just see. Okay, so next we're gonna do the coconut flour, cinnamon, nutmeg, baking powder, lemon zest, and ginger. We're gonna do fresh ginger, which is gonna be awesome. Okay.
Tell everyone what we're making again.
So we're making paleo pumpkin bread. It is made with coconut flour, with almond butter, with pumpkin puree, and with essential oils. So we're just adding in the lovely health benefits of essential oils, their potency, their taste. It's gonna be amazing. All right, so next we have the coconut flour. 1/4 cup coconut flour. And then instead of all the cinnamon and all those spices, we're gonna use the essential oils. Let me clean this out. Ooh, those fresh veggies are looking beautiful.
Coconut flour, ginger. Are you using ginger in this?
Yeah, there's gonna be fresh grated ginger. There's also a ginger oil as well that we could have used, which we're gonna get into using fall because that oil is very yummy. You can make gingerbread cookies. Lots of good ginger recipes for the holidays. It's exciting. Thanksgiving is coming up in a few weeks. All right, so here's the coconut flour. 1/4 cup coconut flour is super yummy. So we got the coconut flour in there. We're gonna do the so does this come with nutmeg? Okay, we're gonna do a little pumpkin spice to get the nutmeg in there. So, again, why do we want to cook with essential oils? So one cool fact I loved was just talking about the potency of essential oils. So if you know, a lot of people like to drink peppermint tea because it's really good for your digestion. Well, one drop of peppermint oil is equal to 25 cups of peppermint tea. So just think about that in your mind. One tiny little drop, 25 cups peppermint tea. That is, yeah. Isn't that right?
It's super concentrated, so just a little bit goes a long way.
Yeah, just a little bit goes a long way. So if you want to help some your digestion, you can just get a little bottle of peppermint oil and put it on your tongue. Makes your breath fresh, helps with digestion. It's great. So that's what we're doing today, is using all those oils. Okay, so this calls for lots of cinnamon, but what we're gonna do instead of putting the cinnamon in is it calls for 1 1/2 tablespoons of cinnamon. Not as a lot of cinnamon. So what we're gonna do instead is we're gonna put like two, what would you say, Toronto? For 1 1/2 tablespoons of cinnamon, should we put like how many drops of the cinnamon bark?
Just one.
Just one drop.
Yeah. It's super concentrated, so you don't need a lot.
Here we go. Very concentrated. Wait for that little droplet to come.
Come on, little guy.
Come on, little guy.
Can you?
Comes. So precious. Just one drop. Oh, we did it.
Wow, way to go.
Yeah, some oils are a little bit more, what's the word?
Viscous.
Thicker than others. So sometimes you're going to see it's a little bit more, it takes a little bit more time for the drop to actually come out.
Yes.
Just be patient.
It'll come.
Patience with the viscous oils.
Exactly.
Molasses.
2 teaspoons. Okay. 2 teaspoons of this. So what is, Tarana, can you tell us a little bit about cinnamon, some of the benefits of cinnamon?
Yeah, absolutely. Obviously it has that wonderful aroma. I just absolutely love it. But it also helps support the immune system. It's also, you know, it's really good for anybody who has like inflammation issues, so it can help support issues like that. We have it in our On Guard for a reason. It definitely supports your immune system. It's a lovely and aromatic scent. It's a really good one for those two main things. So supporting your immune system and supporting any inflammation issues.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Cinnamon is good.
Now we're gonna get some lemon zest in there. I love zesting lemon in things. I just love the flavor. It's just very unique. The taste of lemon zest is like nothing else. So we're gonna do a full 1/2 teaspoon of the lemon zest.
But you put too much lemon drops in there, so you may want to go a little bit less on the lemon zest?
Could. That's good. Good thinking.
I don't know.
You know, today we're
how lemony do you want your pumpkin bread to be?
Well, that is a good question. The lemon adds a lot of flavor and freshness to the pumpkin bread, but you don't want it to be too lemony. So that's why today is a little bit of an experiment, because I'm just trying out these oils with this recipe, because, you know, normally it calls for the spices. So this is kind of an experiment to determine how does it taste with different levels of oils in it. So that's what's fun about these oils, is you can kind of experiment and see what works. Also, you can go onto doTERRA website and search recipes on there, and they have a bunch of recipes already created. That's one of the ones that Tarana is doing, the marinara sauce. That's already a recipe on doTERRA itself. So that's a really good resource you can use for the oils as well. All right, so now we're gonna put the clove and the On Guard in as well. So I think with these, I'm just gonna go ahead and do maybe a drop of each. What would you say, Tarana? What would you say on the On Guard and the clove? How much do you think? Maybe a drop of each or two of each?
I would do 1 drop of clove.
Okay.
Because again, clove is a spicier oil that we have.
Okay.
Another great thing about clove, it is already in the On Guard. So again, helps support the immune system, helps support anything inflammation related, and it's really high in antioxidants.
Oh, cool.
So clove is a really, really great
yes.
one.
Yes. Okay, so we're just gonna put one little drop of clove in here.
1 drop of clove.
Is this a more viscous oil as well?
That's all right. We'll just mix it in really, really well.
I think it got on the edge.
Oh, yeah.
Got on the edge.
That's fine. Maybe 1 1/2.
Yep, there it is. Spicy.
Yes.
Ooh, that's nice. Really spicy. Okay, and then On Guard.
On guard, you can.
Woohoo, that's spicy.
Yeah, again.
She talked all about safety, and I'm just kind of going for it. So, you know, you can be a little risky, like me, but it's best to be safe. So it is quite strong.
It is. For the on guard, go ahead and put 2 drops.
Okay. Yeah. This on guard is so yummy. This is the one she was talking about soaking apples with. You can put a couple drops in your water each day. That's really good to do over the holiday season to keep your immunity up. Mm-hmm. So doing that with the On Guard is good. Another really good thing to do when you're sick is to mix it with some coconut oil and you can put it on your chest. You can put it here by your throat if you're having a sore throat. Also up and down your spine. That's a really good place for the immune system.
That's how I like to take mm-hmm. it. I run out of On Guard all the time just because it's one of my favorite oils. I use it religiously. I use the On Guard with coconut. We have a fractionated coconut oil, and then I just apply it to my spine. You know, the spine has like nerve endings there, so you know, it goes into your bloodstream a lot quicker. Same thing if you apply it to the bottoms of your feet. The pores on the bottoms of your feet are a little bit larger, so you're gonna actually absorb the essential oil a lot better and a lot quicker if you do it that way.
Oh, that's
and also
cool.
The feet have reflex points, so just another thing to mention. What else was I gonna mention? There's something I actually wanted to mention about clove. So clove and black pepper is something that we sometimes recommend to people who are trying to quit smoking because it is, they're like spicy and they're peppery.
Oh yeah.
It kind of gives, it just helps support people that are trying to, you know, quit, you know, a smoking habit. And so again, it's one of those things that you should always dilute it, whether it's putting it in your water or mixing it with like some coconut oil or like flavoring your food with it, because they are spicy. But just another quick little tip on
that's cool. I like
how
that.
To use those two. And another thing, from an emotional therapy perspective, black pepper is it's a good one to kind of like, again, dilute it with some coconut oil or or olive oil if you want, or jojoba oil, that's good too, and just apply it topically, like kind of like over the chest area or like the tops of your shoulders. I heard from an aromatherapist once that that helps, the black pepper helps unmask like negative emotions, negative energy, and it helps with releasing just those negative and toxic thoughts, and also unmasking the root of your problems.
That's cool.
That's a little tip she gave me, so I just want to share it with you guys.
Oh, I love that.
I
really
thought
good.
It was really interesting.
That's
super. Have you tried it?
Yeah. I've tried it with some of the other oils that she had recommended. Because at the time I didn't have the black pepper, but I also used Melaleuca, which is one of the oils that she recommended, which is our tea tree oil, and she also recommended lemongrass.
Okay.
For some people, lemongrass, if they're sensitive to the smell, whether it's they're sensitive to the tea tree oil or they're sensitive to the lemongrass, I mean, you have different options. You have different oils that you can use. And that's another great thing about the essential oils is that, you know, whatever it is that you're going through, whether it's emotional or, pardon me, or physical, I always say essential oils, they're like perfume. So they're gonna react differently to different people's body chemistry. So I always say, you know, if one oil is not working for you, we always have another oil that you can use. We have a lot of options.
That's cool.
Yeah. So that's just my little tidbit on that.
I'm
gonna go back to my marinara.
Yes, the marinara. Okay, so this is what I just did. I just grinded up the ginger, which I love fresh ginger. Really good also, again, for detoxification, cleansing. This morning I did my fresh orange and grapefruit juice. So we have a little press. I do cut up oranges and grapefruit, and then I put fresh ginger in there. Really good for you. So here we go with the ginger. We're gonna put that in there. Fresh ginger. And then we're gonna add together all of our fresh ingredients with our dry ingredients. Get everything going. And the nice thing I like about paleo baking is everything's really rich. It's not as light and fluffy as some of the baking that we're used to. But I like that because it makes it so you don't really need as much of it. It's like, you really don't need so much bread, but really like one good piece of pumpkin bread fills you up, satisfies you, and it's full of really good nutrients. So that's another great thing about paleo baking. All right, so we're about done with the recipe, and we can put it into a bread bowl to cook it. And it calls for 350 degrees, I believe. Yep, 350 degrees, and then you bake it for 40 to 45 minutes and let it cool afterwards, and then you have lovely pumpkin bread for the week to eat in the mornings, afternoon, night, whenever you want. Okay, so we're pretty much looking good on the pumpkin bread here. I'm gonna grab a little tin to put it in. It's looking so yummy, and I'm excited to see how it tastes with all these oils in there. It's gonna be super rich. Yum, yum, yum. So Raya, what are some of your favorite Thanksgiving dishes? Please do share.
Well, ooh, mom smells. Always makes a really good mean bowl of yams.
Yes. What does she put in our yams? It's kind of interesting.
Lemon zest.
Lemon zest and orange honey. Juice and honey.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Super. So you would think, you wouldn't really think to put orange in with yams, but you know what we should try this year is putting orange oil in there. So doTERRA has an orange oil, wild orange, and it smells so good. Oh my gosh, this already is smelling amazing. I can tell it's gonna be so good smell though. The oil's in there. Yes. Oh yeah, she has a good wild orange.
So I love to put a drop or two of wild orange in goat cheese.
Ooh.
It's so good. Mix in a little honey, one or two drops of wild orange, mix it in together, and then mix it with the goat cheese, and then spread it on like some gluten-free bread, and it is just phenomenal.
We need a Toronto's doTERRA in like, I don't know, we need to come up with some clever name.
Yeah.
And blog it and blow it up so everyone can start to benefit from your creative genius.
It's so yummy. And then if you want to garnish, you could always garnish with some arugula just to kind of finish it off.
Let's see how this spaghetti squash is doing.
Young squash?
Ooh, I think it's going to be pretty much done. Hopefully I didn't cook it too long. Oh no, it looks perfect. Okay, so watch how this comes out. I'm going to bring it out of the oven. It's so cool. Because, you know, a lot of people use a spiralizer to, like, do the zucchini and everything. But this just naturally does that on its own. So watch this.
Wait, so you love squash enough, your friends all call you Sasquash, right?
Yep.
That's your nickname?
Actually, I love melon so much that I have the nickname Mo Melon. But you can also call me Sasquash.
Sasquash.
Yeah, Sasquash. Okay, so. See how it looks? Starts coming out with little, like spaghetti.
It spaghettied itself.
It spaghettied itself. Oh. So it just comes right out, just like that. It's beautiful. Doesn't it make you just want to cry?
So you could almost
look.
Leave it like that, and then you could just put your sauce in the middle of it.
Yes, and then eat it right from there.
Then you could take a photo, put it on Instagram, and get a million likes and become an instant paleo food blogger.
Exactly.
In a moment.
There you go. That's what you could do.
If you heard this idea live, don't steal my
idea. Don't steal the idea. Okay, actually, you know what?
Don't you dare.
It could go for a little longer. So
you only put it in a half an hour ago.
No.
No.
It was almost an hour now.
What time is it?
It's like almost 1:15.
Dang, you guys, we've been cooking and grilling and laughing and talking for 45 minutes.
So what else do we need to do for the marinara to finish
So tell me what the marinara is going to be about. What oils do you add in the marinara?
So I diced about 4 tomatoes.
Hold on, what's up with this drawing right here? That's really distracting everyone.
That's just a funny thing that the Arthurs like to do. Uh-oh. Don't mind me.
I didn't see anything.
Okay, anyways, we're gonna just Just know that the authors like to do funny drawings. I just ripped some paint. You know what? It's okay. This is just life. You make mistakes sometimes. Back to the marinara sauce. Okay.
Okay. Here we are. I diced about four tomatoes. I diced about half an onion, and I did roughly around 5 to 6 cloves of garlic. Mm. Personally, I don't like to add too much onion, so for me half an onion is good enough. But obviously, whatever suits your taste. Mm-hmm. You can always improvise. So I chopped those up. And I did wash my hands, but as you all know, when you chop onions and garlics, it tends to leave that residue odor. And so what I did was, in addition to washing my hands with soap and water, I also took some lemon oil, and I just put 2 drops. And
oh, nice.
Yeah, just to kind of, refresh my hands.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah. That's
so
cool.
Yeah, because lemon oil has cleansing properties.
Yes.
So you could do that after chopping some onions. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna take some olive oil and just heat that up.
Mm-hmm.
And then what we'll do is
Michelle Gerard said she loves squash and anything pumpkin.
Yes, I love it. We got both today, the spaghetti squash and the pumpkin. Going real fall staff. All right, so we're gonna put this in here. All right. So we're gonna cook this all up together?
Well, first we're gonna put the olive oil.
Okay.
So let's just do that first.
Beautiful.
Just get the bottom of the pan real good.
Real good.
Real good.
As well as the garlic together first. Okay.
Amazing.
And then I'm gonna just let it heat up for a little bit before I mix in the tomatoes.
Because they take way longer to cook than the tomatoes.
I like to cook the onions really well. Mm-hmm. Not like till they're brown.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well enough. It helps with the flavoring.
Mm-hmm.
So I like to do that first. And then could we just put it on medium to high
yeah.
heat, please? Thank you.
Beautiful. Love it.
May I have something that I can mix the basil
and
the oregano with? Like,
yeah.
Just in an olive oil.
Like a ramekin?
Yes.
A little ramekin.
That's one of my friend's favorite words. Anytime he can say that word, he does. And he makes sure everyone knows he said it.
Love it.
He just loves how it sounds.
I love ramekins. They're so cute, and they're great for making like fun little desserts too.
Yes.
And like puddings.
Mm-hmm. Ramekin.
Isn't it a fun word to say?
It's really fun. You know what? Today, I think I'll go buy some ramekins.
Sounds like an old English word.
It does. I like it. Yummy. Who doesn't like onion and garlic? I mean, come on. So good. So those are cooking. And then do you want me to add the basil and oregano in together?
Let's put in the olive oil first.
Okay.
So what are we doing here?
We are mixing some oregano oil with basil oil.
For the sauce.
We're gonna dilute it first. Because as I mentioned earlier, you don't really wanna drop it into the pot or the skillet, whatever you're cooking with. You don't wanna just drop it over the food because it's not gonna mix in.
Mm-hmm.
It's not gonna be an even distribution of the flavoring. So you always wanna mix it with some olive oil.
Okay.
So we're just gonna do 1 drop of basil. I just want to be really careful because I don't want to do more than one.
Takes a little bit of skill, huh? Intentionality. Ooh, boom.
I got it.
You
okay.
got one.
got one. Another thing about basil that I really like is obviously when we think of basil, we think of, you know, something that's going to be, you know, flavorful for our food. But basil is actually really nice for like a massage too. Mm. It helps soothe tired muscles. It's also a great one if you feel like you have a headache, so it can soothe some of that discomfort of your headache. I like to kind of just put it a little bit like on my temples and like the back of my neck. So it's really good, like if you have like a headache or like just like a tense neck, it's really nice to put some basil oil on. Just again, safety issues. Don't let it go near your eyes, and if you do, you know, get it like put it on your hands and then get into your eyes. Hopefully you won't, but if you were to do that, I always say take like a cotton ball or like a tissue and then mix some like oil, like a coconut oil on there, and then just wipe your eye in case if it ever gets into the eye. But essential oils are not to be meant to go into your eye, and if they accidentally do because maybe you had it on your hand and then you touched your eye, that's just like a little tip of how you can kind of like ease that discomfort. But the basil oil, another great thing about the basil oil is it helps promote alertness. So it's a really fresh scent. I actually really like to, I came up with this diffuser recipe. I like to do, diffuse one drop of basil with 3 drops of wild orange. It's super, super nice because you've got the orange, which is very uplifting, and then you've got the basil, which like just like perks you up, so. Okay, so we did 1 drop of basil, now we're gonna do 1 drop of oregano. Again, another spicy oil that we have. Always, you always wanna dilute this one. Always with olive oil, if you're cooking. If you're applying it topically, definitely with our fractionated olive oil. So we're just gonna do 1 drop.
Yes.
There we go. Just a little something to stir this up.
Oh, yes. And then what I'm doing back here is I'm going to toast some pine nuts to put on top of the spaghetti squash and the marinara. Put some little toasted pine nuts on top. Mmm. Delectable. Should we throw in the tomatoes in with the onions and garlic?
Yes. That'd be great. I'm just going to add some more olive oil.
Perfect.
Make sure it dilutes really, really well.
Now pine nuts, when you toast them, you have to really watch them because they burn super quick. All of a sudden it's like they're golden and then they burn. So you keep an eye out.
Golden burnt?
Golden and then burnt.
Okay, yes, that's exactly the color we wanted.
Perfect.
So do you cook often at home, Tara?
I try, yeah, absolutely. I definitely try. You know, I just think cooking at home, it's just the best way to go. Like, you know what you're putting in your food, you know what you're eating. You know, oftentimes when you go out to eat, you know, you don't really know what they're putting or how much they're putting in there, how much sugar, how much oil, what kind of oil. I'm a huge proponent of like cooking at home, making your own meals, and having fun with doTERRA essential oils.
What type of oils do you try and avoid?
What type of, like, to cook with?
Yeah.
What kind of oils I avoid? You know, I really stick with olive oil, extra virgin olive oil.
When you talk about going out to restaurants and eating, what type of oils are you think they may be using that you don't think are necessarily great?
Just that very saturated corn oil. Mm-hmm. Like, I think canola oil, right?
Canola oil, yeah.
Yeah,
canola oil's not good.
Yeah.
So check your, you know, that's a really good thing when you're buying things from the store. Check what oils are in there. If it's canola oil, you might want to stay away from it. That's not a good oil to use. Like Tarana said, olive oil is amazing for cooking. So is coconut oil. Coconut oil has a really high like boiling point, so it's safe to cook with. It's really, really good fats for you. So if you stick with, you know, olive oil, coconut oil, you're pretty good to go with those two. That's what we do also. So, we're gonna see how that spaghetti squash is doing. This is gonna be delicious. I can't wait to get it in the oven, but we have to wait till the spaghetti squash is done.
So what time is it right now?
Well, it is 1:22, so We could call it a day. So, you guys, that was super fun. Cooking with essential oils is really exciting. You can get creative, start to just try new things. Look on doTERRA's website, look at the recipes they have, because those are a great starting point. And then experiment like we did today. I just picked up that recipe off of Against All Grain, and then I'm experimenting with different oils putting in, and I tried the dough and it tastes so good. I'm really excited. And then this, once we do this, we're gonna put the oil in, correct?
Absolutely.
The basil and the oregano in with olive oil. And then it's pretty much done from there, right?
Yeah. So, you know, once the marinara is cooked, we just turn off the heat, we just let it cool off just a little bit, remove it from the heat, let it cool off just a little bit, and then, you know, you just take the basil and oregano and the olive oil that we diluted and mixed together, and then you're just gonna pour it all over, and then you're just gonna stir it really well, and just make sure that it gets evenly distributed in there. So
awesome! And then you're gonna take your little spaghetti squash. You're gonna do what I was doing: pull all the spaghetti out of there, out of the middle, and then you just basically put it in a bowl like pasta. There it is. See, it's all coming out. It looks beautiful. So gorgeous.
How much was this squash?
That is a good question. I'm not really sure. Was I don't know, maybe around $3, $5, could be around somewhere in
there. No way.
Yeah, and it's an amazing meal.
Not
so
that expensive.
Maybe it's only $2. I don't. But look at that. It just comes all
naturally squashed.
Pop it up. Naturally spaghettied.
Spaghettied itself.
It spaghettied itself. Beautiful.
So
okay.
Cool.
Isn't it cool?
So, I've seen that before.
I know, it's so fun. So there you go. You're going to put that marinara right on top of there. Have yourself an amazing meal. So if you have any questions, let us know. We're going to put these recipes down in the links at the bottom of the video for you to check out. And start cooking with essential oils. Enjoy the nutritional benefits and have fun. Just start getting excited for the holidays and what you can make. So thank you, Tarana, for joining us. It was so fun. And come on in to Health and Balance. You know, if these are some really good tools you can use for, you know, different symptoms that you might be experiencing, such as sickness or autoimmunity or digestive issues, and nutrition is an amazing place to start. But if you want to delve deeper into what's going on and how you can get better, how you can improve on some of those things, we would love to come alongside you and help you. We do an initial biochemical exam to kind of determine where you're at with your health and where you want to go, and what might be blocking you from getting where you want to go, what might be some things that your body needs to... Burnt my pine nuts. Told ya.
Take them out.
Happens quick. Well, they're kind of done. So we're just gonna let those be a mistake. But anyways, as I was saying...
Aw, they look perfect.
They look great. Okay. I think they're fine. So anyways... that's kind of the way that we help you determine how to get where you want to go. It's kind of taking an initial look at what might be blocking your body from healing itself, because naturally it should heal itself. So if you would like to just help us, or have us help you get where you want to go, we'd love to do that. So thank you for joining us on another Lunch with the Doc. We'll see you next Wednesday at 12:30.
Have a good
one. You are amazing.